Switch. Testing.
I hear you.
Yeah, I'm pretty good with that.
Hit.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Boston Pizza 4A Volleyball Championships. Tonight's first semifinal match will feature the number one seeded Lord Selkirk Royals against the number four seed, the Vincent Massey Vikings. This match will be followed by our second semifinal. Trojans versus the River East Kodiaks.
Better here?
Please rise. Everyone, please remove your hats, if you're able, for the national anthem.
True.
HSAA acknowledges we're gathered here on Treaty One land, the original territories of the Anishinaabe, Cree, Oji-Cree, Dakota, Lakota, Dene peoples, and the homeland of the Red River Métis. The MHSAA proudly acknowledges our role in the many relationships that make up our home and commits to a spirit of reconciliation for the future. After this semi-final match featuring the number 1 seed Vincent Massey Trojans and the number 4 River East Kodiaks, the second match tonight will be with the Dakota Lancers and the Glenlawn Lions, and the winners will play in the finals Monday night at 8 o'clock right here at Investors Group Athletic Center. Our visitors on the scoreboard tonight will be the River East Kodiaks. Let's meet the team. Number 1, Brayton Swanson. Number 2 is Jake McDonald. Number 3, Griffin Murray. Number 5, Theo Weeb. Number 6, Dax McNatch. Number 12, Ashton Collar. Number 13, Liam Turkowski. Number 15, Samuel Penner. And number 17 is Reed Cochran. Now, the starters for the River East Kodiaks. Number 4, Matthew Brown. Number 7, Yipsira Kunstler. Number 8, Tanner Nactigal. Number 9, Eli Ulrich. Number 10, Jeff Thistle. Libero is number 11, Gavin Ulrich. The team officials for... We have 2 team officials. We've got Zach Dineball is the head coach. And the assistant coach is Carson Garber. Now, the home team on the scoreboard is the Vincent Massey Trojans. Let's meet the Trojans. Number 1, Jacob Yee. Number 2 is Hudson Penner. Number 4, Tyler Billick. Number 5, Magnus Carlo. Number 7, Brick Kron. Number 10 is Matthew McCarthy. Number 14, Nathan Adam. Now, the starting lineup for Vincent Massey. Number 8, Keon Tor. Number 9, Everett Smith. Number 11, Morgan Eby. Number 12, Shane McKim. Number 13, Declan Verdera. Number 15 is Owen Weeks. Libero, number 6, Mitchell Strilcha. Ronald Dixon, and Abu Epovetchubu. Assistant coaches, Ethan Singh, Ken Cron, Aaron Mitchell-Dewick, and Tristan Maluga. Head coach is Marshall Jones. Now, let's turn this match over to our officials, Juan Rodriguez, Chris Dimitru, Mark Vermet, and our head official, Randy Hall.
Well, hello everybody. Welcome back once again to the Investors Group Athletic Center on the campus of the U of M for this 2023 Boston Pizza Varsity Boys Final Four Volleyball Championship. We mentioned it last night and it bears mentioning again. Every varsity team has had this night circled on their calendar long before the season began, Adam, and tonight 4 teams are left pursuing their dream of being 4A provincial champions. Welcome again. My name is Cam Johnson, here to call the game, and beside me is Adam DeJonk here. Adam, we retreated to some great volleyball action last night in the girls' semifinal, and tonight we'll find out which of these boys' teams will be competing for the provincial title on Monday. Adam, tell us a bit about these 2 teams and what we might expect tonight.
Thanks, Cam. Yeah, this is going to be a very entertaining matchup between 2 very physical young teams here, as we have the powerhouse and the giant of Vincent Massey, Winnipeg. The Trojans, they have not lost a match this season. They're coming in undefeated into this provincial semifinal with a lot of experience on their team. Many grade 12 players, a lot of university commits as well. So they bring a lot of experience with them. On the other side, number four, the River East Kodiaks have been a thorn in a lot of the top team sides all season long. They have chipped away at a lot of tournaments. They've been in finals. They have a lot of youth on their side as well. A lot of these players, JV finalists last season. So it should be a very entertaining matchup between these two teams, as it's going to be number nine, Eli Ulrich, to start us off.
Float serve over and starts off with a good serve. Massey in a bit of trouble, but they're able to handle that one. Little roll shot off of the block. Waiting for the call. The ball is just out the back, and we're right off the hop seeing some of the sides.
Absolutely. There's going to be a lot of physicality, a lot of aggression, especially from the attack side here. That one just a little bit long. Looking for the hands was Weeks. Just none there at the net for him to find.
On the right side set here. Dig from the back row. Matthew Brown with that one. Got Kizzle off of the block. Nice play at the net. But on the net was River East, and so Massey will side out. Going back to serve right now is number nine, Everett Smith.
Smith has one of these hybrid spin serves here. He can rip it with some topspin or mix it up and transition it into a float. We'll see what he elects to start with, and the start is going to be into the belly of the net.
Kind of a soft spin there, and we saw this in the girls' game last night and talked about that as well, getting used to the environment and the situation that they're in, and so we'll see how long it takes for these guys to settle into their game. Noctegal with a good serve. Back set to Weeks, who tips it into the pot.
That's a great selection there by Weeks, as we saw that set. Just going past the antenna a little bit too much, but that is what he brings to the table, is so much athleticism and length that he's still able to retrieve sort of an errant set and make something of it with a great kill.
And we're treated to tonight, eight of the top 10 players are going to be playing in the two matches tonight. Owen Weeks, that we just talked about, number one in the Free Press top 10 pool. That's Jack Kizzle from River East. Hits it outside. Ball goes out of bounds. Point Massey. Morgan Eby back to serve for the Vincent Massey Trojans. Right side set. Setter takes the first ball. Out to Weeks again. We can see that advantage of being able to get that high and stretch for those off-speed balls. Joust at the net. River East comes away with that one. So we're tied at 3-3 in this first set.
You can see the nerves as these teams continue to settle into this provincial semifinal. A little bit of over bumps, a lot of sort of ball control, just not quite how they look for it, as we see a huge ace off the hand of Yepsira Kunstler there. Great serve. But again, just you can see that in Smith's pass there as well. Teams are just looking to settle in, find their rhythm, shake a bit of the nerves as this match progresses.
Kunstler there went after that serve as well, but on the middle of the net, so Massey's going to go back to serve. Owen Weeks now with his first serve attempt of this Final Four match. High contact serve. Passed up in the middle. Outside set. And this is going to be a River East ball. Jack Kizzle does a good job against a very sizable block, off the block and out, providing a point for his team, and he's back to serve right now. Good, solid spin serve. Joust at the net. A little bit of confusion in the back there. I think Weeks was jumping right over Tanner Noctegal in position one.
Yeah, I like the aggression there from Weeks, but maybe just lacking a little bit of communication there, as his setter, Torres, was looking to take that ball. There's another tight pass off the hands.
Pipe set. to Jack Hizzle in the back row. Quite can't execute on that one, but he's coming out of the back row with a lot of speed, and I'm sure we'll see a lot of back row attacking as the night moves on here.
Absolutely, especially actually from both sides, but Kissel is definitely a weapon they like to utilize both front and back row. And setter Matthew Brown, he orchestrates a beautiful offense. He really tries to incorporate all of his pieces, whether it's front or back row. I wouldn't be surprised to see Kunstler on the C-ball option as well as the night goes on.
Well, and there he takes matters into his own hands. Matthew Brown swinging on the second ball there. A nice play to get it back on the River East side.
Yeah, the left-handedness of Brown, definitely a lot of help, but he's probably the most physical setter in the province. He loves to be a weapon at the net. He likes to earn points when he's in the front row. Whether he's swinging or just dumping the ball, he's definitely someone that Massey's going to have to keep their eye on throughout this match.
Theo Weeb subbed in and doesn't quite execute his serve. We'll see if that's a regular substitution or not, and he's coming in to play that role here tonight. Back to serve for the Vincent Massey Trojans now. Shea McKim. Middle attack is dug up and handled by the Massey Trojans off of the block, and it'll be a point. Tying it up, 7-0.
A great pass, and Nactigal is definitely one of the main, or the main middle option for River East. I like Brown trying to get him involved there well, but Massey, clearly game planning, they recognize that, getting two blockers in front of him as well.
Tough serve put over there. Good defense on the Massey side off of a good Eli Ulrich attack. He gets a second shot. He gets off of the block and off his own head and into the stands. He's got a little smile on there and the thumbs up to his setter saying, good set.
Yeah, that
no
was,
worries.
Was a great set, but Keon Torres, that's something he does really well is his block. He's one of the few high school players who's not afraid to show you a shot and take it away with his block.
There we see Matthew Brown. Again, he's going to try to do the two-hand dump, but read in the middle by Vincent Massey, so not able to convert that time as he goes up to try and score. Shea McKim back to serve again. Pops it short. Outside set. Another big block, a solo block that time, and you can see what you're saying, really good structure on that block.
Yeah, solid hands there from Torres, and this time, not so greedy. Doesn't drop his hands, he stays high, but still penetrating the net, and that one just catching his left hand beautifully deep into the court. Another great swing from Ulrich, just a lot of real estate taken away by the Torres block.
I'll see here if they, what their setting set is, or pass, sorry, is in middle of the court, so a down ball put over, and we're still alive here on extended rally. Nope. There's a whistle. Reserve, though.
Yeah, it looks like the head official just got a little bit trigger happy there with that whistle, perhaps not expecting that rally to continue, but he recognizes it. He's going to give the reserve.
Which is the right call, and that did turn around pretty quick. Good defensive play. We'll see if they get the pass here, if they run the middle, knock the goal. Doesn't get the chance, though, as that serve goes out of bounds. River East serve now. Back to serve. The setter, Matthew Brown, for River East. Tough float serve, but handled well by the Massey team. Ooh, and a big attack by Everett Smith, but oh, we have a net call.
Looks like River East is being called for a net violation. Referee two here, seeing something on the block.
A little bit of confusion here on the faces of the River East Kodiaks, so we'll see, but usually the referee wins on that conversation.
Yeah, it's going to stay where it is. We're just getting the score corrected inside IGAC here, and it's going to be Keon Torres back to serve. The Trojans maintaining their three-point lead.
Torres drops it short, a good serve here. Number nine, Everett Smith, with a big solo block on the right side for a Massey point. They're now up 12-4 in this first set. Torres will go back to serve again. This time he likes to put it a little bit deeper, tighter pass, running the 30. What a play. I think that went off of his nose. Another net call.
That looks like that's Everett Smith being called on that initial attack. Once again, that rally just happening so quickly dig that the Trojan side just being a little confused at the whistle. But
yeah, we saw that ball come back and off of the first contact. Shot off those arms very quickly off Vergara's nose and then went back over. The net call's there, but we're going to need to take a little bit of time to get cleaned up there. And we're off to a good start in this first set there. We talked about nerves, but there's some big attacking, some good defensive plays. A few net calls, though.
Definitely.
But we're off to a good start here with Vincent Massey up 12-9 in this first set.
Yeah, and it's really the highlight so far early in this match for me, Cam, has been the blocking. There's been a number of solo blocks, double blocks, and that's something that is one of the harder skills, I think, to obtain when you're at the varsity level. There's a lot of good attackers. There's some really serious setters out there. But blocking seems to be one of those skills that just comes with maturity and experience in the game. And at the high school level, this start has been fantastic from a blocking standpoint.
Yeah, absolutely. And so much of blocking is picking up on the cues and being able to read the angle of approach. And these teams have faced each other. They know each other a bit. But like you say, it is a tough skill, and they've been off to a great start in that regard. So we'll take a second here while we have a moment to recognize the good work of LRSDTV, who is the reason that we're here doing the broadcast. So LRSDTV out of ATC in the Louis Riel School Division, student run, and doing a great job at these championships from a broadcast point of view. That's a very professional operation, and we're happy to be here and to be part of it.
Yeah, we were talking a little bit before this broadcast, Cam, but just can't say enough about LRSDTV and the students who operate here. Now, there's about three cameras at least that I can see that are operating inside the gym here today. There's a director and a number of staff who are out here making this production possible, and we're just lucky to be a part of it and enjoy this wonderful volleyball that we've got going on court. And right on cue there, it appears that Declan Vergara, who was the one who was struck in the face, it seems that he is going to be replaced now on the court, perhaps just still getting patched up a little bit. It's going to be number four, Tyler Billick, checking on in place of Vergara for now. Hopefully Vergara's all right. Hopefully it's just kind of a leak that needs to be stopped and plugged, and it's not anything more. But obviously can't be playing with any blood out there, so it's going to be Billick in replace for the time being.
Well, that ball came off of that first contact with a lot of velocity there. So it's the officials here getting everything set straight, and I think we're back ready to resume play. Eli Ulrich back to serve. Puts a deep float serve. That sails just out the back. Massey will get the ball back as Everett Smith goes back for his serve. And serve handled well by the River East Kodiaks. Misfire a bit on that set. Leek's not quite able to take that roll shot, fix it inside the antenna, so the ball will come back to the River East side.
That's been the 1-2 punch all season long, and that's why it's reflected in the top 10 with Weeks being number one and Tours being number two, but they just haven't been able to find one another here to start this match with that setter-hitter connection.
Here we have a middle attack. Another miscommunication there. The ball drops. That closes the gap here for River East. Now a two-point spread in this first set. Tanner Noctegal going back to try and put another point on the board. Tough spin serve. Schilchuk a little bit tight to the net there, forcing the setter, Torres, to have to do a one-handed set, not quite able to contain it. So now we're in a one-point differential in this first set. Into the net on that serve. Going back to serve now for Vincent Massey. Morgan Eby. Good pass, right side set, and good power from Kunstler. Center did a good job there. Matthew Brown of holding his blockers, didn't tell them where they were going there, and didn't know if they were going middle, left side, or right. Chose the right side, and there was a successful attack. And Kunstler with a good serve. Down ball put over by Brown. And there we see that connection that you were talking about, a nice high reach. Owen Weeks making no mistake about that one, find the middle of the court with a good attack.
Yeah, that's what those two are capable of in terms of finding one another in system. And there's so much tempo to that ball, but also just the vertical ability of Weeks is unmatched. He's up high, snapping that ball cross court, but unfortunately follows it up with a misconnection on the serve there. Definitely not the contact he's looking for, but he'll be shaking that off, I'm sure, as he's one of the many but most efficient back row attackers here at the high school level. He'll be getting some volume there right away, I'm sure.
Yeah, Kizzle with a good serve, but handled well by the Massey Trojans. Shay McKim with a big attack out of the middle there for Vincent Massey. Almost turned the dig there on the River East side too, so they're not giving up by any stretch. They're in the right position. There we see a good serve by Billick. Left side attack, keeping it alive here. Everett Smith there was going for the top of the block, not able to find any hands on that one, so that's going to be a point for River East.
Yeah, it looks like Smith just not getting an approach on that ball, as it was sort of a quick continuation rally off of the kind of roll shot from River East, and he has a responsibility to cover the middle of the court and then get outside to attack, but missing that second piece there.
That time the outside set goes off of the antenna. I thought it might have been the other way around, but I guess not.
It looks like the down official's calling on the net for River East. And we talked about this yesterday night with the girls' semifinals, but most times in most games throughout these high school seasons, you're not getting a second official. So there happens to be a lot more net violations called and seen when you have a referee whose responsibility it is solely for that purpose.
And there we see a middle shot by River East's Tanner Noctegal.
Great selection there from Noctegal. Now his older brother, also a River East graduate who played a couple of years at Briarcrest College, now with the University of Manitoba Bisons, also a middle. So that success seems to just run in the family.
Brown with a tough float serve. And that time, Everett Smith was able to connect. The block was there, but Smith was up, hitting that ball hard, and which is a big part of hitting left side, is to hit the ball hard and test that block, and he came away with that point. Good serve by Torres. Ooh, and there we see a big block by Owen Weeks on the right side. There wasn't a lot of room to hit that ball.
No, that timing on the block was fantastic, which is a tough thing to do when you've got a high ball set coming from the back court like that, for the block to be so well timed, well executed by the Trojans.
And Noctegal gets the set again in the middle, and Massey is on the net. So both teams aggressively blocking, aggressively attacking. We've seen a lot more middle here tonight than we did last night. We'll see if that continues on. Ulrich with the serve, high ball outside to Weeks. He takes a big swing and not able to connect.
Maybe just losing himself in relation to the court there as he tries to hit that cross court shot, but with that set being so far inside, almost to the middle of the logo here, that's just too much court he's trying to hit that's just not available.
Gap is smaller there, good pass. Outside, once again, Weeks. Makes good on that set, and there is a net call again on River East, but that wasn't going to matter. That ball was going to find the floor. 2018, a
It's good to see Declan Vergara check back on for the Trojans. He's got a little bit of work done on the nose, couple plugs in, and but glad to see that he's not injured. He's back out here just plugging up that leak.
Another powerful attack by Kunstler, but can't quite find the court. But man, his approach, he's got a lot of power and a really quick swing. It's a heavy swing.
Mm-hmm. And a great set selection there from Brown, as he had Eby committed in the middle on Nachtigall. He got the one-on-one he was hoping for, just a little bit wide.
Good serve by Smith, puts them out of system. Force in the middle, able to keep the ball alive. Kunstler again with a line shot, that is Doug, and Weeks plays it off the block. And that time, not quite able to find the court there. That antenna's taken a beating.
It is, yeah, it's been a busy night there for the skinny man antenna. A great rally there from both sides. Lots of good defensive play covering their hitters. Both teams, we can tell, they know how valuable each and every point is for these rallies.
Service ace. One-point game now. Massey up 21-20.
Big time for an ace like that, and Nachtigall's been incredibly consistent on his serve so far tonight. It's aggressive, it's a heavy topspin serve, and he's had a lot more makes than misses thus far.
Service is just out, good eye on the line to let that one go. Timeout being called here. We're gonna talk things over here, see if they can put a pause on some of the momentum.
Yeah, I like this timeout from Coach Dybul of River East, as this is the rotation that they really struggled in last time around, which allowed the Trojans to create a bit of a gap here in the first set. That's really the only run that either team had given up. But it was when River East was caught in this rotation with Brown in the front, along with Novak and Ulrich on the left. So I like him taking this time out. Now, Zach Dybul himself, he was a national team setter for a few years back in his day. So he understands the offense pretty well. I'm sure he's got a lot of knowledge and a lot of experience to give to his athletes in a situation like this, and especially his setter, Matthew Brown, in terms of where they want to go with this ball after the timeout.
Yeah, you can see him talking to his team and kind of talking about the block, I think, a little bit as well. We don't have the coaches mic'd up, so we're kind of guessing at what they might be talking about. Monday we'll have mics in these timeouts, but like you said, lots of experience in these coaching staffs, and they're calm and collected, which rubs off on the players as we see them going out with a pretty business-like attitude, confidence on both sides, and good reason to be. Float serve, and as we see often enough after the timeout, just out the back.
Yeah, and it's, you got to be relieved there if your Coach Dybul just really getting you out of that rotation that you don't want to be in. But it's passed up there. They go to the right side, and that's what Owen Weeks does best, and he's done all season long, is bury that ball cross court.
And Adam, you've had an opportunity to watch this team as one of the coaching staff members at the St. Paul's Crusaders. You would have played against this Massey team a couple of times this year.
Definitely. We've seen that shot a number of times throughout this season.
Weeks serves out the back. Back to serve for River East now is Jack Kissel. The one-point set here right in the very end. Tight scores, 23-22. He's looking to tie it all up here. And he is able to with the service ace on the back line.
Now, Jack Kissel, and it's described in his Free Press Top 10 write-up. Now, he's ranked number 8. It says, clutch hitter who leads by example. And this is a player who's not just defined by his attacking, but his serving as well, as he's clearly confident and comfortable, and he's been doing this all season long, going back at big moments and not taking an ounce off. And that he's rewarded with at a big time there, evening this one up at 23. And Coach Marshall Jones with Vincent Massey, he's going to take a timeout to address things.
I would like to take a couple minutes here, too, to recognize our partners and sponsors here that make this all possible, starting with our title sponsor of Boston Pizza, followed by Sport Manitoba, the Dairy Farmers of Manitoba, Manitoba's Credit Union, Canadian Armed Forces, Manitoba Hydro, Huddle, Luscious Orange, and Mikasa Canada. A big thank you to our partners that make this championship possible. It is an exciting time of year and a big part of the high school season, these provincial championships, as we see the stands start to fill up. We see the team colors. We have a mascot in attendance here from Vincent Massey, so a great atmosphere for these final four matches on the boys' side here last night with the girls' side. Great matches there as well. It's a great time of year if you're a volleyball enthusiast.
Absolutely. Yeah, this is just, there's nothing better than representing your school colors and that logo and getting out here and trying to hang a banner in that gym forever, as it's going to be Jack Kissel booting us back up here in this first set.
Another tough serve, but handled well, and we have a tip, a timely tip out of the middle by McKim. So that swings the possible game point into the hands of the Vincent Massey Trojans. Tyler Billick coming into the game. He's going to have the ball in his hands here to see if he can end this first set.
Now, this is a very common serving sub from the Massey Trojans, as Coach Dybul on the River East side is going to allow Billick another 60 seconds to think about this serve coming up. But as I was saying, Tyler Billick, he's in this role a lot with this Vincent Massey team. He comes in quite regularly to serve for Vergara in the back row and typically stay in there and pass and defend. So unfortunate that Vergara was hit in the face earlier in this set, but it did allow Billick to get a little bit of court time, get a little bit of comfortability out there so far, rather than just being tossed in at quite a crucial time.
At a crucial time, absolutely. Well, and this is what you practice for, and especially when that is your role. And as you get to varsity, that is often what it is, right? You have a role given to you, and when you're on a team that is that strong as well, that's your opportunity to contribute. So it's a great opportunity for Tyler Billick here as the timeouts come to a close and the teams make their way back to the court again. Possible set point here, 24-23 for Vincent Massey. As you mentioned there, they haven't... They are undefeated this season, and that with that comes a lot of confidence in these situations.
Yeah, absolutely, and they have been pushed at times. They have had a couple of five-set victories under their belt as well. Not a lot, but they have been pushed at times, so they're definitely a team that's not new to adversity in these kinds of situations.
Let's see what Billick can serve up. Float serve into the middle and outside set. Massey's going to have an opportunity to swing for this set. Not quite able to convert is Everett Smith on the left side, going for a sharp left side attack. Hits it into the net on his own side.
Yeah, just maybe a little bit too ambitious with an angle like that, finding the tape and rolling back onto his side. And Kodiaks, they can breathe a little bit of sigh of relief now.
Theo Weeb subbed in to serve again at 24 all. This time he makes good on his serve. Middle set. McKim is on that one, 51 into deep five. That's a tough spot to defend against if it doesn't hit the block. You don't put defenders there for the most part. So he makes good on that and scores.
Just such a quick attack, Cam. He was in the air well before Torres was releasing that ball and just beating the block with speed.
Kim back to serve now. Outside set. Well, he didn't take anything off of that attack, but Ulrich unable to find the top of the block, so that gives Vincent Massey a 26-24 first set victory to start this first match in our boys' semifinal.
Incredibly entertaining start here, Cam. Lots of, a little bit of extra there for us as we pushed it past the 25 mark. And River East, a very talented team. We expect some adjustments to be made from them after this first set, and a lot of pushback as well. And the encouraging part on their side is you definitely didn't see them fearing the moment in that situation. As we saw, unfortunate attack error there from Ulrich to end the set, but it's still an aggressive swing nonetheless. You can tell he's not scared of that opportunity or that moment. Same goes for Jack Kissel, serving aggressively and consistently late in that set as well. It's just very encouraging for River East moving forward, even though they didn't get the result they were looking for in the first set. Lots of opportunity, and they continue to play the right way.
And in a 26-24 score, you know, that's different than switching sides and losing 25-17 or something like that.
Right.
That's a bigger loss. And 26-24 is you just have to find a way to maybe make one less error here and then score a point or two there, and that's the difference. So they have a lot of reason to step on the court with confidence once again. And Vincent Massey with the win on that first set, you know, that's going to help them as well. So, who knows? We might be in here for a very long night once again.
That's all right. We're buckled in regardless, and we're excited no matter what these teams have to throw at us.
And when you get to this stage, the rankings, the 1, 2, 3, 4 matters a lot less than it does throughout the season when you get in this environment with everything that's on the line. And these teams have also had, they haven't been playing every two nights, and they're not coming off 3 weekends of tournaments either. So they're healthy. They've been focusing on one night and one team for a week now, which is not something that you get to do very often in high school.
No, never, Cam. And that's a great point, too, which allows these teams to come in with such an elaborate game plan for their opponents. And in a lot of instances, especially with these two teams, they've played each other a lot throughout the season, despite River East being from the KPAC conference and the Massey Trojans being from the Western Conference. They still do see each other a lot throughout the season. So they're familiar with one another. I'm sure both of these coaches try and compile as much video and information from other teams as well throughout this process and planning. And it's always interesting and impressive to see how these coaches kind of adapt on the fly as well.
And that brings up a good point. A lot of our viewers may not have the experience or familiarity with this game and to truly understand how much preparation and game planning exists. And these coaches are watching tape, they're taking hitting angles, they know passing percentages, hitting percentages. The high school volleyball level of play is very high, but so is the coaching and the experience there as well. We have a lot of coaches that have been involved in high school, but provincial team and club, and the community of volleyball is such in Winnipeg that so much learning happens, and you see it applied here in these situations. Just about ready to start the second set here. Vincent Massey Trojans now on our left and River East to our right. Back to serve, number 8, Keon Torres for Vincent Massey. And River East gets off to the start that they want to have. Tanner Noctegal in the middle with a 51. Puts the first point up on the board for River East.
Love the selection from Brown right at the start of this second set. Go to the middle, establish the middle, open up things for your outsides.
Doesn't follow up with the serve he would have liked there, but lots of volleyball left in this set. Everett Smith back to serve now for Vincent Massey. Serve goes to position 6, an outside set. They have a net call on the offensive side that time. Jack Kissel being called on the net.
Looks like it may have been the setter Brown called on the net there. As Coach Dybul, he's always
trying to
asking.
Figure it out too.
Yeah, he's always asking this down official who continues to be on the net, because that's probably 4 or 5 violations for River East alone already.
Service goes out the back with good velocity on that, and that's a different type of miss. I always, when I'm coaching teams, I think, you know, if you miss just out the back, that's volleyball. When we're putting it in the net, that's a little tougher one to handle. Right side to Weeks, and he makes no mistake about that one once again. Nice attack, cross court for a point.
That's 4-5 now for Weeks, just pure cross court on a one-on-one block. I'll be curious to see if River East makes any adjustment from their left side blocker to try and maybe take that angle. Now we know Weeks, he's capable of hitting the line as well, so it's one of those darned if you do, darned if you don't moments.
Well, and I'm thinking that even in a well set up situation, he might be able to just go over top.
That's right.
Well, a smile there on the face of Aguera, who tried the kind of the beach shot there and wasn't able to quite get it as far as he wanted into the zone net, so that'll be a side out for River East. Jack Kizzle back to serve now. Good serve. Back set again, 2 weeks, so he's starting to warm up here. He's finding his groove, getting up high, hitting that ball hard.
We've seen this a lot from the Trojans all season long, where in the first set they try and establish their offense, get everybody involved, sort of open things up. But as the match progresses, they begin to go to weeks more and more and just let the big dog eat. And that's, I think, what we're beginning to see as this offense and this match progresses.
Tight set by Weeks, but that doesn't matter with Torres in the front row. Scores on the setter dump there. One thing, Adam, I'm noticing here is the serve receive has been very solid on both sides, and that's why we see scores of 26-24. It's not coming on the heels of a bunch of errors. These teams are serving tough, but they're passing well. And of course, as I say that, right?
That's always how it works. The commentator curse in full effect this time. River East at the brunt of it on their serve receivers, yeah. But a tricky one there. Weeks with the changeup that he's capable of, also catching the net tape, that can just catch the serve receivers well too deep into the court. Tough break for the Kodiaks.
Deep serve, there we go, another service ace for Owen Weeks. Now, Adam, we watched your game, your conference final game, when it was being played at Vincent Massey. It almost seemed like Owen couldn't fully reach her, he'd be touching the ceiling on his serve. So it's kind of fun to watch him here in the bigger venue, being able to stretch out fully. Good pass by Kizzle. Bit of a scramble here, but they managed to keep the ball alive. Vergara does a good job on a well-formed block, but he was hit with a lot of power off the block and out. Now we have a bit more of a sizable lead. We haven't seen this yet tonight. 8-3 Vincent Massey right now in the second set. So River East will call the timeout and try and settle this down and get back into it.
That's a good point, Cam, as this really is the first big run that we've seen. It's at the hand of Weeks at the service line. Now, a lot of coaching experience in your day. If you're Coach Dybul, what's the approach here, as they haven't seen a deficit like this just yet?
It's reminding the players again, and I mentioned this last night, you can only control what you can control, and that is the first contact. Maybe trying to move and give the serve receive a little bit different look as you go back to serve. Maybe we shift a little bit to the left or to the right. The little games within a game, the little bit that might change. But I think it's important for players to just remember their role. This is what I'm going to do, and I'm going to execute it, and then you do you, and you execute it. We better the ball, and we go one point at a time, and truly believe that there's a chance here. And then we mentioned it as well last night, not to look to 25.
Absolutely.
We're going to look to 13 or 14 when it's 8-3 and keep that manageable.
We'll see if River East can implement some of these tactics here as they exit their timeout. Definitely a lot of positivity on the faces and body language of the Kodiaks. We'll see what they can make of it here.
Well, the timeout does its job, and Weeks puts that one into the net. And if you can defend this point, Adam, 8-5 now is the score, where you're now just playing volleyball. You're not looking at too much of an uphill climb. It's tough, no doubt, but it has a lot different look than 9-3.
Definitely, I agree with you there.
Float serve, but that's not the response that you're going to want. Kind of looks up to the ceiling. He's a little bit frustrated with himself, but that's okay. And he's going to get another chance to answer back, as he did in the first set. That's Theo Weeb. Vergara back to serve for Vincent Massey. So he checks out his serving target. Deep float serve, and that happens. So that kind of cancels the last missed serve, and it'll be a River East chance here now. When I played a million years ago, my coach Chris Green, he would be on us all the time that if the other team missed a serve, we had to score. We had to make that error count in our favor. And it's always stuck with me. It's not always possible, but it's a good mentality to have. Another solo block here. Everett Smith with the solo block, and then some fancy footwork in his celebration thereafter.
Yeah, that's when Massey's at their best, is when they are playing with a lead like this, is they turn up their aggression, they turn up a little bit of their risk-taking, and when it begins to pay off, like a big solo block we just saw, then they have that kind of swagger in their step. But in order to combat that, you need to respond, and that's what we see beautifully done from River East in that rotation as they go pipe to Kissel.
Yeah, Kissel, that was a great set. It was well ahead of the attack line, fully in system. And a primary play there. That was a great play. Well, like you said, they're rolling here, and Everett Smith makes no mistake on that one, and hits that left side ball.
Yeah, great tempo on that set, and that was one of my favorite sets to hit when I was playing CAM, is that pass that's overloaded to the left side, but you keep your middle in front of you and just flick that ball, overload, catching that middle blocker just a little bit late.
Oh, and what a dig by Mitchell Strelchuk. Unfortunately, his teammates are on the net, but that was a one-hand dig on a very hard shot.
Yeah, you rarely see liberos in the top 10, as they are just kind of one of those unsung heroes of the volleyball court.
So.
But Strelchuk, he makes his way into number 10 here on this year's ranking, and very well deserved. He really anchors that backcourt for the Trojans, and he's more than capable of making spectacular back row plays, as we just saw.
Yeah, that was a one-hand dig on a solid shot there. So it'll be fun to watch him the rest of the night here. Smith back to serve now. A little bit of a roll shot, takes something off his serve. Lots of elevation on that particular attack. Kissel makes good on it. He had a big block with Weeks in front of him, but that was a lot of compete happening very high over the net.
Yeah, and just he's attacking that ball at his peak, Cam. He's got his full extension on the arm, challenging that block. That's what you need to do.
Good positioning in the back row. Eli Ulrich with that dig. Oh, there's a run that we haven't seen a whole bunch. A quick set to Weeks. Kind of a 62 type set there. And with the middle coming quick and the 60 coming out of, that's a tough play for the blockers to handle.
And especially in transition, Cam, as the River East block, they're just trying to reset off of that rally, that dig and free ball. And in order to keep your eyes on your responsibility, sometimes it can get lost in transition, as we saw there.
Kissel misses his shot, just misses, deep to position five. And that is where you gotta be hitting if you're the River East attack right now, is high and deep. It sounds cliche, but that's where you're gonna hit the top of hands or deep court. Middle attack there. Strong middle attack. Jonathan Novak with that kill.
A little bit of a give and go there from the middle. Not something we see all that often, but great team serve receive from the Kodiaks as the front row middle. He knows his responsibilities, those short balls, those tape balls, and he executes beautifully for his Kodiak side.
He got the arm swing on that one. He's a little jammed up there, so that ball goes quite a bit long. 59 now for Vincent Massey. Owen Weeks going back to serve.
This is the server who built this run initially.
Right.
We'll see if River East can try and shut it down as quick as possible.
Not this time, as he serves into the net. You mentioned it last night, just taking a little bit more time in that pre-serve routine, and I think that could be something that would be helpful to some of these servers, but you do get excited in the moment there, and sometimes that extra little rush is what makes the difference. That time, Weeb makes his serve, and we have a block in the middle. Tanner Noctegal with
That's
the block.
Impressive re-blocking there from Noctegal. His responsibility first and foremost is that middle attack. Despite it being off of the net, they forced that 31, but Noctegal, he sticks with it. Great read by him, not just bailing out and going to the outside.
C-ball to Weeks here, who puts a roll shot in there, and after you swing as many times as he has, that opens that shot up, that little bit of a beat shot, a little roll shot right in the middle where you got your defense locked in for what they think is the big shot coming.
Yeah, heads-up play there from Weeks to change it up. We haven't seen any sort of off-speed shots from him yet.
No,
so
yet.
He's earned that respect so far tonight to keep the defense on their heels. But That's what a well-rounded attacker can do, is really diversify the shots they bring your way.
Tyler Billick in the game and back to serve, and he puts in a good serve. Bit of a collision on the river east side, but they're able to handle it. Eli Ulrich with a nice shot there. He was going off of the block that whole time, and he executes exactly the way he wanted to. That's a smart attack. Matthew Brown back to serve. Tough float serve down the line in position five. Smith is going to take a swing at it. And he executes that attack.
Yeah, great positioning there from Gavin Ulrich. He's cross-court, but when it takes such a strange deflection off of the block, it really changes the angle that you're viewing it. Tough pickup for him.
You can see the spin coming off of the hands there, too. That adds another level of difficulty. Just out. Not by much there at all. And McKim thought he got that back line, but we have line judges that are right there making the call, so it's going to be a River East serve now. They have closed the gap again here a little bit, so we're sitting at a 17-13 Massey lead. Eli Ulrich is going back to serve now. We have some conversation at the score table. Not quite sure what that's about, but seems to be in order. Over bump there, and we have a net call. Keon Torres in that joust was just on the net, so that'll be another River East point. And Ulrich will get another serve.
Now this is sort of a run that River East needs to look to build sooner rather than later, and perhaps it can be that net violation that sparks them to try and combat some of the pressure from the Trojans.
Well, we're seeing some good serving here by Ulrich's. Their tactical serving down the line at Everett Smith. They want him to pass the ball to make his life difficult as the left side hitter here, forcing him to take it with his hands and rush what he wants to do out there. We'll see if they go back with the same idea. They did. Roll shot. And Smith executes.
That's two or three now for the Kodiak side, where it's these off-speed balls. You know, you force the Trojans into their B or C shots, but unfortunately, they're just not able to come up with those sprawling digs, and those are the ones that you might think, if only we had that.
Yeah, you look back at the game there, and now Smith has got a block on a little bit of a tight set there. Ypsira Kunstler didn't have all of the room that he needed to be able to attack that ball. And Smith wrapped it up pretty tight over the net. Service is long.
Couple errors from the service line starting to compound for the Trojans, and that's leaving the door just cracked open enough. Like, it's just a matter of time here before the Kodiaks decide to try and kick it down.
They're going to have to play a clean remainder of this set, especially if they have to make up ground on 3 points. This is a tough team, this Massey team, to do that when you have that kind of passing and that kind of outside left side set. Completely in system. Nice attack by Owen Weeks.
Yeah, you mentioned he has the ability to just rise up and really neutralize a block no matter what they take away by just how high he's contacting the ball. And that was a perfect example. Why hit a shot when you can just go over top?
I can't relate. Never could. Maybe you could, though. Hitting the tape again, but River East able to keep it up. But they're going to have to give a free ball here. 31 set in the middle. Morgan Eby gets his kill. He's excited about that. Turns to his setter. High five.
That's a big reason why the Trojans have been ranked number one all season long, is the ability for different players to contribute offensively. We haven't said Eby's name much at all tonight, but he's still more than capable to score for them when his number's called.
Nice pass by Kizzle. They're going to run there. Middle, but we have a net violation again.
Looks like a carry ball instead, called by the head official.
Oh, we have a carry ball and the net there.
Coach Dybal not happy with the call, but he's going to call his second timeout as the lead continues to sprint away here for the Trojans. They now lead by six, and they do also lead 1-0 here so far in this match.
Well, the Investors Group Athletic Center starting to fill up here. Lots of fans, and we've got the drums out.
And this is only half capacity here, Cam. As we know, Monday night's finals for both the boys and the girls typically have both sides of the stands opened up and available for spectators. But tonight, just the one side, but it's still a lot of great representation. We're seeing some polarized blue to our left and green to our right, but a great turnout from all the supporters as well. There's got to be upwards of 300 people here in the building right now taking in some of this top quality high school volleyball.
Today I was looking online just out of curiosity as to when of these teams, when was the last time they made their way to the final? And correct me, viewers out there, if I'm wrong, or if you're a member, an alumni, going, no, Cam, that's not it. But I believe this is Vincent Massey looking for their first title, I believe.
I believe you're right. As to the best of my knowledge, I know they made the finals two or maybe 3 or 4 years ago now. But no, as far as I know, they do not have a 4A boys high school title.
And on the River East side, it's been a little while. They as well have been in the hunt for sure a number of times, but the last time that they were able to call themselves provincial champions was in the 1982-1983 season, I believe. Again, if there's alumni out there, I apologize if that's not correct, but both these teams have some history that they want to correct, and one of them is going to be going to the big game on Monday.
Yeah, absolutely. So clearly two programs that have been in the hunt and hungry for it for quite some time, and we know process of elimination, one of them is going to have that opportunity on Monday.
For sure. So we saw a little bit of questioning here. Coach Zach Dybel there wondering about some of these calls, not seeing it quite the same way. Good shot by Kizzle. Stiltruck with the dig. Free ball coming over to the River East side. Another dig. Perfect location. Well, that was a good, powerful rally. Great outside attacking. Stiltruck with two very big digs.
I love that rally for Stiltruck. The first one kind of spun off behind him, and he slapped his hands together right away. He knows he's capable of a cleaner dig, and he immediately gets a chance to clean it up and does just that. Great execution from the young libero.
Good reaction by Brown there to keep this ball alive on another serve that hit the top of the tape. I'm going to try to go back into the middle to Morgan Eby, unable to connect there. They're talking it over, a little smile on his face. Let's see what they run here. If he goes back to him, gives him another shot on it. And service hits the top of the tape there, and the ref says, nope, that hit the floor. Point River East.
River East is going to need and hope to string a few more of those lucky bounces together as they're continuing to try and claw their way back.
Tough jump float here to Weeks. Well, it was a good retrieval, a nice cover dig there by Gavin Ulrich, but in the end, another big block by number 15, Owen Weeks, on Vincent Massey.
Yeah, just good ball recognition there, as that set was left inside from the bump set of Brown, but Weeks follows it, stays inside as well, allows EB to set to him, and there's just nowhere to go.
That ball floats quite a ways out the back. He's got a smile on his face though, Morgan Eby. Easier to smile that one off when you're up by a few points. Kissel with another good serve. Once again, Weeks jumping over his center.
Yeah, he does what he needs to do to try and be a weapon when it's called, when his number's called. And despite the sloppy one-handed attempt there from Torres to keep it alive, he goes after it.
What service ace right in that conflict zone. We haven't seen that particular kind of ace yet. We talked about it a little bit in the broadcast last night, but serving that ball deep between two players, waist high, forcing them to have to make a decision and get into each other's space. Not able to recreate it though, so that gives Vincent Massey 25th point in a 25-21 win in this second set.
Yeah,
well in command now as they head to the third set of this first of two semifinals.
Yeah, great push and great response there from River East and at certain times, but it was ultimately just the service pressure of the Trojans that was just too much. We didn't see a lot of Nachtigall, who is someone who was incredibly successful offensively for the Kodiaks in the first set. Just wasn't able to get involved due to a little bit of struggles from the serve-receive side. So we'll see if the Kodiaks maybe address that and try and bounce back and just tighten up that one aspect of their game. Could do a lot for this response here in the third set, as it is backs against the wall, do or die time for them.
Well, when you look at, when you look back at sets that you lost, you often zero in on those points early in sets when there was a 3 or a 4 or maybe even a 5-point spread, and you don't notice, you chip your way back and it becomes a 2-point or a 3-point game when you're coming close to 20. But and that's what we saw there. They fell behind early in that set and was just a little bit too much to be able to come back from later on in that set. And on the Massey side, they're rolling. They've got a lot of options and clearly a very talented team as well. So they're not going to let up at all or take it easy.
Yeah, I made mention of it in the midst of that set, Cam, but a team that's familiar with playing with the lead, they're familiar being in the driver's seat throughout their high school season so far this year, and being up 2-0 is another part of that. This is definitely a familiar area for them. They are typically leading in these moments, so this is something that I expect them to just continue to put their foot on the gas, and as I mentioned, I wouldn't be surprised if we saw even more of Weeks as this set continues, and this match continues, and this third set starts, because that just seems to be their dynamic. When they need to score points, when they can almost see that light at the end of the tunnel, that finish line, they try and give the ball more to the man who typically is getting them close to those opportunities.
On the River East side, it's exactly that point that, you know, you have a team that is often used to being up and being up 2 sets or being in command. So when it is close, the ability to execute and put pressure on a team that maybe hasn't felt all of that pressure, win this set, give them a different look, change the narrative a little bit. That's the opportunity that lies here. That's a little bit well hidden, I guess, maybe in the way the game goes in the score, but that's kind of how you have to look at it as a River East team is, let's see what they do with some adversity when they have to fight their way back and test a little bit of their resilience.
Now this is a relatively young core here for the River East Kodiaks. Both the Ulrich twins are in grade 11. Their setter, Matthew Brown, grade 11. And the middle Tanner Nachtigall, also grade 11. So a lot of the contributing pieces to their team, they're youthful. So this is maybe something that perhaps a little bit of ignorance is bliss in this moment, where they can come out maybe a little naive to this moment and continue to just ball hard and see what happens for their team.
Eli Ulrich will start it up for the River East Kodiaks here in this third set. Back row setter call here. Strochuk with the pass that was just a little bit too tight for a back row setter. So Keon Torres forced to go over the net, not quite able to keep it on his side. So 1-0 to this third set. Tight set and able to contain that. Oh, we're seeing some good plays at the net by Theo Weep here. Owen Weeks had a couple of opportunities, and if he gets a couple or a few opportunities, you know he's going to make good on them eventually. But in that rally, Theo Weep in the front row was able to block the first one, extend the rally. He put over against that block a third ball there attempt as well, so that was a good sequence for him. finds the backdoor shot right there.
Yeah, nice little change up here for personnel for River East, as you mentioned, making quite the contribution at the net so far, and we'll see if that can continue for him. And it's just great to see him contribute. Clearly a role player on this Kodiaks team, but when his number is called, making the most of this opportunity thus far, and you can see his teammates really rallying around him, yeah. And that's producing some energy, which is much needed for River East.
Andrzejkowski out to serve off the top of the tape. Solo block, Gissel on Owen Weeks. Nice block for the River East side, and that goes a long way to building confidence as well.
That's a good reminder that Weeks, he is human. You can stop him, you can get some touches on him, and despite maybe that block going out of bounds, it caught Weeks on the way, so he'll take the blocks however way they'll come.
Another good serve by Jurkowski, and now that ball is out. 4-1, River East. This is the start to the set that they were looking to have.
And I think this is definitely going to change the approach from the Massey side as well. They're not going to have that same level of comfort with such an early lead as long as River East can maintain so far.
Oh, that's a good serve. Just out the back, unfortunately, but a good job by Liam Drakowski, who comes in and gets a couple of points for River East. Pat on the back from Coach Dybel, letting him know, good job, kid, you did well. A little bit out of system, the right side attack, and another kill. Theo Weave off of the block. He'll go back to serve now. Deep to five, a little bit of trouble there. It's gonna force Massey to give a free ball. Quick set outside. What's going to be the call here? The ball lands in, but I think that he had... Is that Kissel that hit outside?
That was, yeah. He just seemed to kind of escape that tight set by exiting outside the court, and that is a legal move. You're not inside the boundary of the court as long as your body stays outside the playing surface, but going outside the net. Good body control and awareness there from Kissel.
Absolutely. Back set to Weeks, off of the antenna and out, so now we have another River East point. Theo Weed back to serve with a 6-2 lead for his team. Good pass right in system, middle shot there.
Great pass from Smith there, and that's exactly what Massey needed, was just to reconnect with their tempo offense, get themselves out of the run that they've kind of been finding themselves against from the Kodiaks. Just good fundamental, simple pass.
A little bit of an off speed there by Weeks. Well, kind of a modified arm swing there by Vergara. Able to connect on the left side. Spin served by Weeks outside to Kissel. This block, we have a four contact. I don't know.
Not tough. I don't know if I saw a fourth contact there.
I was counting them out, but some confused faces. But again, the guy in the stand is going to make that call. Float serve now goes deep. Side off of the block. Once again, Jack Kissel answering the call there. He's had a great game tonight. He's done very well, an efficient attacker, and he's not shying away from that block at all. Lots of power there.
Yeah, and he's scoring in multiple ways off the block. He's had that cross-court shot we saw right just two rallies ago. It's a good variety, but unfortunately our tires pumped him a little bit too much, and that ball travels long.
We gotta back off.
That's
on
right.
Stuff when they're serving.
Timeouts is our time to talk about how well everybody's playing.
Yeah. But give him credit. He's playing. He's not holding back. We mentioned that already, which would be understandable in this kind of a situation, in this venue. But these players are not doing that. They're playing full out, which is good to see. Guerra back to serve. Serve to five, handled very well. We see that pipe coming up. Ball is blocked. Some big left side attacking from both teams right now. The tips and rolls.
That's just neither team really finding their rhythm in transition, not really getting much of an approach was either left side Smith or Ulrich, but Massey, they're bailed out by the net touch there when Brown tries to play it off of the bottom net tape, just catching his fingers a piece of that net.
And they go middle, River East goes middle. Jonathan Novak with the kill. He hasn't got the ball a ton, but he's done well when he has received that pass. He's jumping very high. That was a high contact.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that's maybe something that River East should go to a little bit more, is with the speed of Novak, he's beating the block, and obviously the weapons are on the outside for the Kodiaks, so it does hold that middle that extra little bit. It does give them a good chance to exploit some middle.
Vincent Massey coming back. McKim with a middle shot of his own.
More good speed there out of the middle. Fantastic run and connection there from Torres to McKim.
So River East side here, Tanner Noctegal up in the front. We'll see if they go to him. Eli Ulrich out on the left side. Goes to Ulrich outside. That is a big block by Torres.
Just pressing so far over the net, Cam. That ball barely left Ulrich's hand from the River East side.
He did not have many angles to choose from there. There we see the force. Looking for the touch call, but there's no touch call there. I'm not sure that there was or not, but none of the officials saw it, so there was no touch. Kim back to serve. A bit of a spin serve there, and they go middle. Knock to go. Smith high off of the block. Ball comes back to Brown. I thought it might take a swing. Was opted to try and do a tactical play. Might have maybe a tip, but fortunately for him, goes into the net.
I think just trying to maybe do too much there, perhaps saw the two blockers in front of him and changed his mind last second, where it's difficult to make that adjustment in the middle of your jump. So
I thought setters always wanted to hit.
That's right. As the setters I know sure do.
Now he's going to go back to serve now. In a one-point game. Now his team trailing by 1 point. Can't quite get the job done there. Service into the net.
That's what Vincent Massey does so well. They've now completely erased the lead and turned it to their side, but they can just play so consistently, and their transition game is just sharper than most.
Going for a pretty precise serve there, just missing off the side. Ulrich back to serve. Big front row for Vincent Massey here. Go into the middle, it's dug by River East. Gissel able to find the right hand of the block and out to the side, so that's another good attack.
Yeah, we saw him sort of hang in the air there, Cam, delaying his attack on the ball, and that forced the hands of the big Massey block to have to retreat to their own side, allowing him to use it to their advantage. Good change up of pace there from Kissel.
Ooh, Meek's looking for a touch call on that, but not to happen. So that ball is out the back. Another River East point. Boy, if you're the setter for Vincent Massey here and you're looking at your hitting options right now in this rotation, you almost freeze up just by saying, what do? I got too many options.
Yeah, exactly.
Everybody's to go on the right side. Off of the block, off of Kissel's hands, and into the antenna. Smith back to serve. We're all tied up here in this third set, 13-all. Well, I really like the way that Jack Kissel is his approach to that left side attack right now. He's not trying to beat the block sharp or down the line. He knows it's a big block, and he's taking that strength and making it his strength right now, and he's hitting off of the hands and doing a great job. Another service error by River East. Those ones are starting to add up here as we see them, unfortunately.
Yeah, and it makes it difficult, obviously, to build any sort of lead or momentum on your side as it continues to just deflate any kind of run you can have.
Yeah, the good news is it is 14-all, so we're not, you know, when that happens, when you're down by two or three, it stings a bit more, so he'll regroup here. Good pass. Right side set, this time not able to connect there. That was a little bit too far for number five, Theo Weeb, on the right side.
Yeah, it's the substitute, Braden Cron, here in to serve, and just a good consistent serve. That's really what you're looking for from a substitute like that. Just put the ball in play and try and give your team an opportunity to steal one.
And get on the stat sheet with that dig. Good job by Brady there. Good attack on Shea McKim. Cuts that 51 back to position one. Nice up high, and that was a very sharp attack.
Yeah, nice play, and great contribution here from the sub. Cron has great free ball pass, great sprawling dig, and he continues to make this serve and put pressure on.
Short serve to two. Creates a free ball opportunity. Vincent Massey trying to go back in the middle to McKim, but a little bit of a miscommunication there. And so the ball will go back to Theo Weeb on River East. Cron coming out of the game there, but like you said, did a good job at the service line and got a dig. Well, that one just got out, but he had handcuffed the Vincent Massey serve receive there.
Yeah, Vergara, he's laughing that he just got out of the way. That ball seemed to have a bit of a tail to it and dipping down as
it did.
He was doing his job following that serve, making sure it's out, but it almost caught him on the way.
Good pass in system. Kissel, another hit. And another attack off of the block to score. Weeks almost turns that dig. He's in the right spot, but wasn't quite able to do it. So Jack Kissel back to serve. Last time we talked about it, kind of Lost the contact out the back. Let's see if he can answer back this time. Not quite a better serve, but not quite able to. Tyler Billick coming back into the game for Vincent Massey. Billick with a good serve over to position two. Causing some problems over there. That time, Everett Smith makes no doubt there. We've seen that shot attempt a few times tonight, and that time he's able to find the court right inside that sideline. So that's gonna be a timeout now. Zach Dival calling for his River East Kodiaks as the Vincent Massey Trojans find themselves up by 3 points, leading in this third set, 19-16.
Yeah, just some serving woes there from River East. That's really been the problem that they can't seem to answer. But Vincent Massey themselves, we have to give credit where credit's due, and it's been some fantastic attacking from across the board. Now, in between the second and third set, I kind of had the thought or the expectation that Weeks would be more involved here in this third set. If they've almost gone the other way, they've began to have different set selections, and people like McKim, who has a number of kills so far in this set, we've seen Smith contribute a little bit more as well. So there's been a lot of different attack options, and again, that plays into the strength of this Trojans team. That's why they're such a difficult team to play against and to really push, is if one player maybe is having an off night or it has a lot of attention on them, there's so many other options to go to.
Well, we're in the last bit of this set here, and we'll see what kind of push River East can put together. We're at that critical time there. It's nice to be within a point, and the first team is hitting 20, so we'll see if they can answer here. What kind of set? Whether they go to Novak here or outside. Find some hands. There's Eli Ulrich. They haven't set Jonathan Novak a bunch, like we said, but I was curious there, just based on that last attack, if they might go there in an unexpected set, but they went outside to Ulrich and he got the kill. And there we have a service ace, a timely service ace. Ibsira Kunstler out there.
Yeah, we haven't seen the Trojans get aced much at all tonight, despite some really aggressive serving from a number of Kodiaks, but that's a timely one, as you said there, Cam. We'll see if Kunstler can follow it up, and he does, and more trouble for the Trojans.
They're able to keep it alive, but that's going to be a free ball. Good job by Brown. Over the net call. We're all tied up here.
Now that's the threat that Brown brings, is they know he's a left-hander who's capable of turning and scoring on that ball, so you get a little bit greedy and a little bit overzealous trying to make contact with that ball, but that's the run and that's the response that Coach Dybul for River East has to be happy with. They were trailing three, but after that timeout, they've erased it.
Yes, and this is that push that tests the adversity and the ability to deal with it. And there we have, off the top of the tape. Torres does a good job keeping that one alive. Let's see if they can execute here. A little bit of a scramble play. We have a middle shot. Shea McKim, you've talked about him, how he's made a contribution in this set, and we see it right there. He's hitting that deep court to five, and that's, if it doesn't hit the block, that's not going to get dug unless you happen to guess right.
Absolutely, and a variety of shots from him. We saw him cut one back to position one a few attempts ago. That's a deep shot, just making it a nightmare night for his opposition block.
And he goes back and serves a service ace. And just like that, 21-19. Just when you think you're inching your way in and you cannot take a breath at all. Oh, we have a ball in the court, so we're gonna have to redo this one. Kim back to serve. It's into the net.
That timely ball on the court, just making McKim sort of restart his process. Unfortunate result there for him, maybe just throwing off the rhythm.
Calling for the set, telling the setter, I want that ball. Service goes long, though. And that's going to give the ball back to Vincent Massey right now as Keon Torres goes back to serve. The two-point lead in this third set. And so with a good pass, and they run that 31. Good choice on that set, and Tanner Noctegal, no doubt about it, able to find the court.
Yeah, that's a great block again from the Trojans. Two blockers up between Eby and weeks, but just fantastic speed of the arm from Nakadal, not allowing them to take away any angles before he's making contact with the ball.
And they need a stop here to keep it alive. What? Just about another big hit from Smith.
Yeah, great choice there from Eli Ulrich to dive into that seam. He's so aggressive in the middle of the court there, but just too much power off the hand of Smith from his one right side opportunity. And
that was a great read by Ulrich there. He was in the perfect spot. Little bit of spin as that ball hit the block. I think if it would have been a clean attack, as big of an attack as that would have been, I think he probably would have turned that dug. It was just a bit of side spin off of the hands.
Yeah, we've now got just 2 points away for the Vincent Massey Trojans trying to clinch their 4A finals berth. The last timeout now taken from Coach Dybul at River East. We'll see what the response is here as their backs are against the wall. There's limited time for them to respond and not just score out of this timeout, but steal a few to try and turn the tide.
Exactly. That's what's going to have to happen here. They're going to have to steal a point and then defend a serve here as well. And that's a daunting task with a team that's been passing so well on Vincent Massey's side, plus the attack that's coming at you. It's a tall order, and you can talk about block defense, but when you have that much firepower, you need things to go very right for you and just a little off for them. But it's possible, and we've seen it before, absolutely. They've come back out of the timeout already in this set to
That's
see
right.
if they can do it again.
That's a great point, Cam, and it's possible. It's going to be Everett Smith back to the service line now. Declan Vergara checking back onto the floor in place of Tyler Billick, just delaying the restart of this set that little extra.
Oh, Jack Issel's in the front row right now for River East, along with Noctegal and Weeb. Alex to go back to the right side to Weeb. He's getting the job done there. He's doing a great job.
Yeah, I don't think he's made an attack error. I think he's three kills on four attempts. That's fantastic efficiency. And for just his first court appearance in this match being exclusively in his third set, that's fantastic production. And I think the Trojans, they got to keep their eye on him as this set continues.
Absolutely. Tendrakowski gets the serve down. They're going to see, and Gissel gets the block on Owen Weeks. We talked about it out of that timeout. Can they do it? Can they shave off that point, defend the serve? And there we see it, 23 all on that big block by Gissel. Just outside, he's jumping up, he wanted that one, didn't miss by much, and now Vincent Massey going back, possible set.
And we're once again going to see Braden Cron check back on for the Trojan side in place of Morgan Eby, and it's a tall task for the grade 11 student here to come in and try and serve for the match for his Trojan side. He did a great job his one court appearance prior.
Pretty fun if you can say that's what you did.
Great pass
outside.
From
Reese. Back outside to Gissel again, and he's going to hit it off of the block and into the antenna.
I love it. That's just a heavyweight tilt on that side of the floor.
That is the perfect way to describe it. Yeah, it is indeed.
Gissel and Weeks just continuing to go back and forth at one another. Fantastic, and we're once again going to get some extra points here overtime in this third set.
Often you'll see in that situation an extended rally there where it's going to be a tip or a roll, but not that time. Viv Reese is going to get a chance to swing out here for a point, and blocked outside again. Gissel goes up the top of the block. We have a net ball that swings the advantage over to the River East side of the court. They're now up 25-24.
Yeah, that is just an untimely net violation, but a great call there from the down official. And Marshall Jones, head coach of the Trojans, he's going to have to intervene and call his first time out of this set as the Kodiaks, they have new life. They've outscored the Trojans 4-1 here after their last timeout. Fantastic response from them.
Absolutely, and they knew they had to do it. And when you come out of those timeouts, you've been as a player, and you know you're saying the right things, and you're showing your teammates the right things, but deep down you're going, boy, this is going to be tough. Can we do this? And it doesn't take too much more than this to really give you a lot of belief that absolutely we can do this for sure.
Absolutely, and that's just kudos goes to Jack Kissel right now, as he has just not shied away from the moment. He's stayed aggressive on all of his attacking, and he's really been the one to put points on the board for the Kodiaks in crunch time, and that is not an easy thing to do, but he just seems like one of those reliable athletes. He doesn't seem to be wavering in his approach or his mental capacity to bear that weight that his team is putting on him for that responsibility. So we'll see what the Trojans' response will be coming out of this timeout. Not something we really have to say so far tonight, to see how they respond in this moment. A lot of good attack options for them right now, but I'd expect this ball to go to the workhorse, Owen Weeks.
I'm sure that he wants it to go his way as well, but they elect to go in the middle.
That's a great choice as well, Cam, as we saw the block of Novak. He's anticipating the right side ball. He's nowhere to be seen on that middle run, but McKim has been as serviceable as anyone on their side of the floor.
Yeah, he's had a great set there, and he provides the opportunity to his team. Bissell handles that Owen Weeks serve. Big swing again in the block on the right side, so that shifts the balance down the other side here. We're in extra points once again. Possible match point, Owen Weeks back to serve, so he's in the back row now. If you can get the ball back on your side, that makes a difference. Best service just long, not by much, couple inches, but definitely out the back there, making it interesting.
And that puts the weapon of Kissel to the back line as well. He has had his struggles here in this third set. See if he can iron it out.
And he does. The good serve, but handled very well by Vincent Massey. Yeah. Well, as an official, you don't want to have to make that call, but it's the right call. Little bit too sticky on that.
That's one of those moments that you just wish you weren't put in a situation to have to make a play like that. Just a reaction play from Kissel coming out a little bit sticky, as you mentioned, but it is the right call. It's an unfortunate call, but it is the right one.
Yeah.
This is not the rotation the River East Kodiaks want to be in this moment.
We'll see what they do. They let off the hook, making it interesting here.
And we're starting to get to that point in the set with this extended score, Cam, that coaches need to start worrying about how many substitutions they've used.
That's
a good
point.
You can't get caught with perhaps the wrong personnel going in to serve, but not being able to bring them back out. I'm not really sure where they're at, but definitely something to keep in mind.
Side just handles it well. Good second effort there. Free ball coming over short to Massey into the middle. And McKim makes good on that one. Inside the block and the net there. But you're right, that's a good point. I've been in that situation where that you get going, you're starting to count 12. That's a lot, but boy, oh boy.
That's right. I think I did just see the call from the down official, River East. They don't have any more subs. That's 12 for them.
What a timely set. The pipe set. Kissel, what a great job. Good choice.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree more with you, Cam. Great choice and great execution. As you mentioned, that ball allowing Kissel to contact at his peak, but with momentum to go through the front row out of the backcourt. Fantastic execution.
And that takes confidence to set that. That pipe set looks like an easy set, but it's one of the tougher ones to make. And Everett Smith saying, not so fast. I got something to say about that, and he has a nice attack on the left side.
Yeah, when he has time to get his approach and be in system with that timing of his attack, he has been virtually untouchable tonight.
Outside here. I'm surprised they didn't go into the middle. But that is 30-28 to the Vincent Massey Trojans, so they're going to move on to the final on Monday night.
Yeah, fantastic match from both sides, and very fitting that Owen Weeks gets the winning block for his side, but kudos goes to the River East Kodiaks.
Absolutely.
They put up one heck of a fight. They were in this match the whole way, and just a couple bounces here or there, things could have changed, but ultimately the consistent pressure of the Trojans just too much to handle, and that is exactly why they have earned their number one seed and now earned their spot in the 4A boys provincial final on Monday.
So to recap here, we have Vincent Massey winning tonight against the River East Kodiaks with scores of 26-24, 25-21 in that third set that we just saw, 30-28. So they will be booking their ticket to the Monday championship final as we await to see who they're going to be playing in our second match coming up here between conference rivals Dakota Collegiate and Glenlawn Collegiate. And they'll be competing to see which one of those two teams is going to face this Vincent Massey Trojan team.
That's going to be another exciting and familiar matchup there. We're very excited for that one as well, and I'm sure the Trojans are just as excited to see who they are going to be facing on Monday night. And congratulations to all the athletes in the 6 o'clock semifinal, and especially congratulations to those grade 12 athletes on the River East Kodiak side for their wonderful high school careers and the contributions they've had to the sport of volleyball in this province.
Absolutely, and you had mentioned it earlier, the